The man you have just seen on the screen behind me is film director Steven Spielberg. He made this speech at the Academy Awards in Hollywood when collecting the Oscar for Best Picture for the film Schindler's List. That was in 1994, 6 years before I was even born. But 23 years later, his message continues to ring true. Only now, the number of Holocaust survivors around the world has sadly but inevitably dwindled. Here tonight, in Manchester alone, the UK's second largest Jewish community, we have seen for ourselves how few are those amongst us who endured the horrors of the Holocaust. Yet, while we remember what 6 million Jewish souls died for, how do we remember what those who survived lived for? For someone like me, a 17-year-old Jewish sixth former whose own family wasn't directly affected by the Holocaust, I've become acutely aware of how difficult it is with the passage of time to honour the survivors and remember the victims. How do you enshrine their testimony for all time? How do we make sure that the Holocaust, as Steven Spielberg says, never becomes a footnote in history? For while books are written and feature films are made, even films like Schindler's List, any survivor will tell you that nothing, nothing comes close to the reality of the horrors they suffered. Earlier this year, I travelled to Poland as part of the King David and ACE trip for pupils in year 12, aged 16 and 17 years old. At first I wanted to go because I thought it was just something that every Jewish person did in the sixth form. But slowly it dawned on me that I needed to go, to see the theatre of the Holocaust for myself. No longer would I imagine places like Auschwitz as depicted through a filmmaker's lens. By standing there and seeing the shattered ruins of death factories and ghettos, I would connect with the Jewish people, my people and my heritage. Though all of it had a profound effect, perhaps the most surreal place for me was Majdanek, the first camp I visited since arriving in Poland. Situated on the outskirts of Lublin, a major city, around 120,000 Jews died in this terrible place. The day we went, the temperature plunged to minus 20 degrees. Despite my thick coat and multiple layers, the cold seemed to seep into my very bones. How could anyone, let alone those who were starved and brutalized, survive this place? I didn't think it was possible to feel another person's pain, especially a person I'd never met, but I couldn't have been more wrong. I stood in the corridor to the gas chambers and listened intently as our guide told the story of a 17-year-old girl, my age, who had arrived at Majdanek with her mother. Whilst the girl was sent to work, her mother was sent to the gas chambers. She never saw her again. Thanks to the random choice of others, she was given the chance to live, but at what cost to her family? Now, as a teenage girl in 2017, I stand here and remember her, even though I never knew her, to make sure her survival lives on in me. I returned from Poland in sorrow and hope. Now I embrace my Judaism, wear my Magen David with pride, and realize that we all have a choice to speak out against evil, stand up for our Jewish values, and take responsibility. The murdered 6 million couldn't choose life. We can choose to remember those lives and be the best that we possibly can be.